Good morning students, I am Kamal's teacher. Today we can teach about subject commerce, unit 4, human resource management, chapter 11. The topic of the lesson is employee selection process. Before you going to teach about, see the previous topic, we can sum about last mass. Meaning and definition of recruitment, recruitment process, sources of recruitment, and then finally recent trends in recruitment. Okay, now today we can see about the chapter 11, employee selection process, under the topic steps in employee selection process. Second one, what are the factors influencing selection process? And third one, what are the importance of selection? And then fourth one, selection differs from recruitment. And fifth one, placement. And sixth one, what are the significance of placement? And finally, what are the principles of placement?
So these are all the topics we can saw the last class. First, recruitment means the process of finding suitable candidates for the various posts in an organization. It is a process of attracting people, potential people to apply for a job in an organization. It encourages the prospect employees to apply for the job. Now we can see the employee selection process. The first, now let us look at steps in selection process. A comprehensive, that means a complete selection process, includes various steps. Selection is process of choosing the most suitable persons for the vacant position in the organization. Now we can see given by the definition of personal management and industrial relations. The authors says, according to their order, says selection is the process in which the candidate for employment are divided into two classes. Those who are to be offered employment and those who are not. And David Robbins, another one author's name is David Robbins, says that selection is a managerial decision making process to predict which job applicants will be successful is here. So there are two authors give some idea and definition of the selection of process. So selection is the process of differentiate between applicants in order to identify and hire those with greater likelihood of success in job. Then we can see the next topic. What are the steps in employee selection process? Look at the picture. Steps in selection process. A comprehensive selection process involves the various steps. The first one is application blank, and after scrutinizing the applications, finally selection test. See the picture, left and right hand side picture, employee selection process. There are five employees is here. So only one candidate pick up in the hand. The red color person. This meaning is right person. Who is the right person in a right job. This is a employee selection process. The first one, application blank. Candidates are given applications form to collect the information from above the candidate. Then the selection committee's shortlist. The candidates from the application reserve, that is done in scrutinizing. Then second one, how to scrutinizing the application. Now the shortlist candidates for selection test. What the candidates qualified in the selection test? The qualified interview, they have face to face interaction between the interviewer and interviewee. If the candidate qualified in an interview, sometimes the qualified for physical examination because the persons are poor health, cannot work completely. After that, then there is after which selection committee says list of candidate. Some candidates kept in waiting list for the approval from higher authority. Then the successful candidate who passed through the various steps of selection process is called final interview. The candidate are brief or told effort, organizations, cultural values and for the rules and for the policies. The candidates also given the freedom to seek its classification. Then finally, selection test. Various tests are conducted to ensure whether the candidate possesses the necessary qualification to fit into various positions in the organization. So after final selection is made, the process completed, certain document or signed by the organization contract is made. So these are the steps in employee selection process. The selection test is classified into two categories. One is ability test and another one is personality test. Ability test under aptitude, achievement, intelligence and judgment. And then personality test under interest, personality, projective and attitude. The first one, ability test. It means measures skills, mental aptitude, problem solving, knowledge of particular field, reasoning ability, intelligence, etc. This test is used to find the suitability of a candidate. The aptitude test, it means measure the set of skills required to perform a given job. It is measured in 12 ways. Aptitude test, it will measure the set of skills required to perform a given job. It is measured in 12 ways. So, and then numerical reasoning test, verbal reasoning test, inductive reasoning test, mechanical reasoning test, diagrammatic reasoning test, spatial reasoning test, situation judgment test, mental arithmetic test, vocabulary test, and the last one, number sequence test. So there are 12 ways the measure in the aptitude test. The first one, numerical test. Numerical reasoning test provides information about candidate's numerical aptitude. So in other words, this test measures the candidate's ability to make correct decisions from numerical data. Then second one, verbal reasoning test. The written text and ability to arrive at factual conclusion from the written test. Then third one, inductive reasoning test. It means measure the problem solving abilities and ability to apply logical reasoning. Then next, mechanical reasoning test. It measures the engineering students' ability to apply engineering concepts in actual practice. Then fifth one, diagrammatic reasoning test. The candidate's ability to understand the shapes, abstract ideas, and ability to observe and extract values. So apply them to new samples. Then sixth one, spatial reasoning test. The candidate's ability to clearly manipulate and remember the shapes, still images, and find out pattern which govern the sequence. Then seventh one, situation judgment test. The most desirable action to critical situation using his judging ability. Then next you can go to mental arithmetic test. It tests the speed of doing calculation. And ninth one, vocabulary test. The test measures candidates' ability to recognize the relationship among the ideas, think methodically, and fluency in English language. Then finally, number sequence test. This measures the candidate's ability to find a logic in a series or pattern. Under this test, candidates have to find out missing number in a sequence to determine the pattern. So these are selection of the aptitude test in 12 ways. Then second one test, achievement test. Then second one, achievement test. It means it measures the capacity to achieve in a particular field. So it is also called as proficiency test. For example, a driver may be asked to drive a vehicle to test his driving efficiency. Then second one, a music student may be asked to play a given instrument. And then finally, teacher candidate may be asked to give a demonstration. Then third one, intelligence test. Intelligence test are one of the physiological tests that is designed to measure a variety of mental ability, individual capacity of a candidate. The main aim of this test is to obtain an idea of the person's intelligent test. So it measures a variety of mental ability and individual capacity of a candidate. The main aims to obtain an idea of the person's intelligence potential. Then fourth one, judgment test. So this test is conducted to test the presence of mind and reasoning capacity of the candidates. So these are all called achievement test. Then fourth one, the second one test is personality test. Personality test refers to the test conducted to find out the non-intellectual traits of a candidate, namely temperament, emotional response, capability and stability. There is no right or wrong answer in the test. It comprises. So, this test is conducted to find the non-intellectual traits of a candidate. So, it is divided into four types. The first one, interest test. It measures a candidate's extent of interest in a particular area so that the organizations can assign the job which suit the team. Second one is personality inventory test. Under this method, standard questionnaire is administered to the candidate to find out traits like interpersonal rapport, dominance, introvertness, extrovertness, self-confidence, lawyer sign quality, etc. So this method uses to find out the candidate's traits like interpersonal rapport, dominance, introvertness, extrovertness, self-confidence, etc. Then next, projective test or the thematic appreciation test. This measures the candidate's values, attitude, apprehensive personality, etc. out of the interpretation. Then fourth one, attitude test. This measures the candidate's tendencies towards the people, situation, action and related things. For example, moral study values, moral study, value study, social responsibility study, expresses attitude test and the like are conducted to measure the attitude of the candidates. Then fourth one, interview. The next step is selection process is interview. The term interview has been derived from French word enter, where that means to glimpse or to see each other. In other words, interview represent, the term interview has been derived from the French word. Okay, in other words, interview represents a face-to-face interaction between the interviewer and interviewee. According to Scott and others, says an interview is a purposeful exchange of ideas, the answering of questions and communication between two or more person. It is to be an interview. Then what are the types of interview? Behavioral and the first one is preliminary interview, structured interview, unstructured interview, fourth one in-depth interview, fifth one panel interview, stress interview, telephone interview, online interview, group interview, video conferencing interview. The first one is preliminary interview. So this interview is to see whether applicants are suitable for both mentality and physically. So this helps the employers organization to cut cost and time in selection process. Then second one, structure or guided or planned interview. This interview is a standardized way of comparing job candidates. The employer creates interview questions focused on the skills and abilities the company is seeking. Structured interview. Unstructured interview is quite contrary to structured interview. There is no pre-prepared questions. Interviewers determine the suitability of the candidate based on the response to the random questions raised in the interview. Then, fourth one, in-depth interview to test the level of knowledge of the interviewee. The candidate can explain its skills, qualification, experience in a detailed manner. Then fifth one, panel interview. It means where a group of people interview the candidates, it is called panel interview. It ensures more reliability in the selection of the candidates. Then sixth one, stress interview questions. This type of interview is conducted to test the temperament and emotional balance of the candidates interviewer deliberately creates stressful situation by directing the candidate to do irrational and irritating activities. So what would you do if a credit for your idea and got a promotion, 7th promotion, was the stress of your previous job too much for you? What would you do if a colleague admitted to lying on 3 resumes to get the job? What would you do if a customer verbally insulted you in front of co-workers? So it is called to be a stress interview. Then next one, telephone interview. So this is interview is conducted for the people who lives far away from the organization. It is typically called as phone screening. Then eighth one, online interview. In these days, interview are conducted by means of interview via Skype, WeChat, Google Duo, video chat. They saves a lot of time, money and energy. It is to be an online interview. Next, we can see 9th one, group interview. A group interview is a screening process where you interview multiple candidates at the same time. So instead of spending 5 hours interviewing 5 candidates and individually, 1 hour can be spent with them in a group. The next one, physical examination or medical the last one finally a video conferencing interview. This interview is similar to face-to-face interview. Video conferencing interview is a kind of conference call that connects the candidates with companies located across various geographies. So this interview is a kind of conference call that connects the candidates with companies located across various geographies. It is called to be a video conferencing interview. So these are called the types of interviews. Then fifth one, physical examination or medical examination. The last technique used in selection is, the selection process is medical examination. The physical fitness of the candidates under selection to be job concern. The physical fitness of the candidate under selection to the job concern. The second one, to protect the existing employees of business organization from the infectious diseases likely to be spread by the candidate selected. The last one, to check excessive expenditures in the treatment of selected employee after placement. Then sixth one, a reference check. Application bank contains a column for the candidate to furnish the list of persons to be contacted for reference purpose. So usually application blank contains a column for the candidate to furnish the list of process to be conduct for reference purpose. Employer organizations used to send either standardized form to reference or request them. Then seventh one, approval by higher authority. The selection committees sends the list of candidates selected with some candidates kept in waiting list for approval by higher authority, like chairman. Higher authority means chairman, HR director. HR means human resource management director, CEO, chief executive officer. CEO stands for chief executive officer and the like. So once the list is approved, the selected candidate will be called for final interview. Then final selection. Finally, the last point is final selection. The successful candidate who passed through various stages of selection process will be called for final interview. So these candidates are brief about the rules and regulations of the organization. So at the end of the final interview, even the candidate under selection is allowed freedom to seek clarification or make his own demands, if any. So after the final selection process is completed, creation documents are expected to be sorry, final selection means the successful candidates who pass through various stages of selection process will be called for final interview. Then, ninth one, contract of employment. It's a very, very important point. After selection, the final selection process is completed. Certain documents are expected to be signed both by the organization and the candidate. So, after the final selection, the process is completed. So, creations documents are expected to be signed both by the, very, very important line, both by the organization and the candidates. The following basic information which need to be included in a written contract of employment varies according to the level of the job. Generally, it contains details like job title, duties and responsibilities, how to expectation of the say scale means salary, to pay, allowance, increments, working hours, date when continuous employment started and basis for calculating service, work rules, grievance procedures, disciplinary procedure. So these are called the selection process. Then we can see the next topic, factors influencing selection process. The first one, nature of post. Second, number of candidates. There are five factors. First one is nature of post. Second one, number of candidates. Third one, selection policy. And fourth one, cost factors or budget. Finally, level of best. The first one, nature of post. The process of selection of employee varies according to type of personnel to be recruited. For instance, selection process of proportionary officer of a bank differs from that of selection of officers for Indian Police Service. So, the process of selection varies according to the type of personnel to be recruited. The second one, number of candidates. The selection process depends on the response of candidates to the advertisement for the post. In case of many, shortlisting needs to be done. Then, third one, selection policy. The selection policy and selection process are interrelated. For example, some organizations go for tougher selection process while some organizations go for shorter method. Some organizations go for tougher selection process while some organizations go for shorter method for the selection policies has to be followed. Then fourth one, cost factor or budget. This is a longer selection process. It is a longer selection process. So entails higher cost organization which candidate which cannot offer large resources tend to shorten the selection process. Then next one, level of education, qualification and experience and exposure. The selection process depends on the best. For example, selection process of finance officers, architecture, treasurer, etc. is shorter as only few candidates compete with higher qualification. Then next topic, what are the importance of selection? The first one is, what are the importance of selection? Is very very important things. So importance of selection is under the a good talent, better efficiency, required cost of training and development, reduced turnover, job motivation, other benefits. So these are the important point. The first one, good talent. People selection system enables the organization to appoint talented persons and thereby leads to improved productivity and profitability. It is to be a good talent. Then second one need is better efficiency. The selection of right person to the right job, the selection of right person to the right job is sure to produce better quality of work and may facilitate faster achievement of objectives. Then third one, reduced cost of training and development. So it means better selection of candidates definitely reduces the cost of training because qualified personnel have better grasping powers. Then fourth one, reduced turnover. Proper selection of candidates contribute to low labor turnover. What is labor turnover? What is labor turnover? Labor turnover, the staff turnover can be defined as the rate of change in a firm's labor force. So you need to know the following formula: number of staff leaving divided by total number of staff into 100. So use in this formula can easily find out the labor turnover. Then fifth one, job motivation. If the right person is selected for the right job, it tends to motivate the person to work more effectively and efficiently. Then sixth one, other benefits. The proper selection of candidate reduces absenteeism. It's very very important. Avoid the absenteeism. They would pay better attention to their jobs and take safety precautions which minimizes workplace accidents. Then selection differs from recruitment. The next topic, selections differs from recruitment. The recruitment and selection play a vital role in the human resource management. So these are the two sides of the same coin, but there exists some difference between the two. The difference have been highlighted and the exhibit is given below. So what are the difference between recruitment and selection? The first one is meaning. Recruitment means it is an activity of establishing contact between employers and applicants. But selection, it is a process of picking up more competent and suitable employees. Then second one, approach. Approach under recruitment is positive one, but selection is negative one. Then third one, objective. It encourages large number of candidates for a job. It attempts at rejecting unsuitable candidates for the selection. And fifth one, it is an economical method, but selection is, it is an expensive method. It's a cheap, expensive. And then sixth one, contractual relation. Recruitment, it involves the communications of vacancies. So no contractual relations is established. But selection, it creates contractual relations between employer and employees. Then seventh one, process. It is a simple process in the recruitment, but selection process is, it is a complicated process. It's a simple process in recruitment, but complicated process in the selection. Then time. Recruitment is less time since it merely involves just identifying vacancies and advertising them. Hence, less time is needed, but selection, it is more consuming as each and every candidate has to be tested on various aspects before selecting the candidates. Hence, more time is needed. So these are called the difference between recruitment and selection. Then placement. So under the topic is, what are the significance of placement, and finally what are the principles of placement. The first one is placement. The process of placing the right man on right job is called placement. The right man on the right job is called placement. The placement may also be defined as the determination of the job to which an accepted candidate is to be assigned and his assignment to that job. The process of placing the right man on the right job is called placement. In other words, placement is a process of assigning specific job to each and every candidate selected. So there are two principles is followed in the placement. According to Dan Order defines, placement may be defined as the determination of the job to which an accepted candidate is to be assigned and his assignment to that job. So what are the significance of placement? The significance of the placement is given below. It improves employee morale, then it helps in reducing employee turnover, it helps in reducing conflict rates or accidents, it avoids misfit between the candidates and the job, and it helps the candidate to work as per the predetermined objectives of the organization, and then it involves assigning a specific rank and responsibilities to an individual. Finally, what are the principles of placement? There are five principles that are followed at the time of placement of an employee. The first one, job first, man next. The second one, job offer. Third one, term and conditions. And fourth one, aware about penalties. And last one, loyalty and cooperation. The first one, job first, man next. Job first, man next. The man should be placed on the job according to the requirements of the job. There is no compromise on the requirements or qualifications of the man with respect to job. So first job, then second one, job offer. The job should be offered to the man based on his qualification. Qualification is based on the job offer. Then third one, terms and conditions. What are the terms and conditions? The employee should be made conversant with the conditions and culture prevailing in the organization and all those things relative, that say relating to the relating to the job. Then fourth one, principles, aware about the penalties. Penalty means collect the fine money. The employee should also be made aware of the penalties if he or she commits a wrong or lapse. Then finally, loyalty and cooperation. When placing new recruits on the job, an effort should be made to develop a sense of loyalty and cooperation in him so that he or she may realize his or her responsibilities, responsibilities better towards job and the organization. So these are called principles of placement. So students, today we have to learn about under meaning and definition of selection, standard steps for selection process, what are the importance of selection, what are the difference between selection and recruitment, define the placement and what are the significance of placement, and finally principles of placement. So lesson is over. Understand the concept. I will give some assignment. Complete and send to me. Thank you.